NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 47 in our series, Creator RubyGem, NerdDice. And in this episode, we're going to be taking some repeated code and refactoring it out into a module that will mix into the two classes that both use it. Our use case right here is the randomization technique equals method. You can see this is it in the die class, and this is it in the dice set class. It is, I believe, verbatim the same. String one, we've got string two, they're not perfectly equal. Oh, that's because I had trailing space in one, not in the other. Let's go back and compare apples to apples here. Now they're equal to each other. So this is probably a bit of overkill if you're thinking about having a module dedicated to one method. I mean, technically we can also move the attribute reader into the module as well, but this is to illustrate, this is educational videos, we're illustrating some of the things that you can do and the techniques that you can use to refactor repeated code. So one of the concepts and that's common throughout Ruby programming is the idea of don't repeat yourself. When you see DRY, the acronym there, or talk about drying up your code, that's what we mean, is you don't want to repeat yourself. This is very much ingrained into the Rails ecosystem and culture. So we'll give ourselves a shot at doing this. And we shouldn't need to modify our specs at all. We're just taking code, refactoring it out, and if we include it properly, then we'll be able to do this. So we're going to create a module within NerdDice. So I'll create a new file. We'll call it We'll call it Sets RandomizationTechnique.rb. I'm not in love with the name, but. And then we'll use one of these as an example. We're not going to have a class here, and inside we'll have a module. So here it'll be module, and we want it to be upper camel case of that, we need to include it in NerdDice. So we'll go up to our module. We don't need to include comparable. We do have the attribute reader here. And then we've got our randomization technique method. Gotta close our module. And I'll write the module level comment here, noting that it's a mixin that can be included in the other classes. So we've got our module level comment. We'll now try saving this. And including it in DiceSet and die. I set those in the wrong order. So now I should be able to get rid of randomization technique. Randomization technique equals. Do the same thing in die. And see if we still pass. Oh, I have done something wrong here. So we're trying to require this, and I did it wrong. Die. Space it. No, that did not help. Line 3, line 20, line 22. Let's see what happens when we try to go into the console. Get the same error. Maybe if I just try that. Initialized constant. So I'm getting an uninitialized constant. Sets randomization technique. NerdDice. that spelled correctly. Module NerdDice. Module. Keep that in the die class rather than in the module. Initialized constant. Maybe my order of requiring things matters. What happens? I require this, or I require these. Then it works. So you need to be mindful when you're requiring that you require them in the right order. So my mistake here was that I was just doing things alphabetically, and I'm requiring here the sets randomization technique. I had it below nerd dice die and below nerd dice dice set. And the problem there is that it's referencing the code before it's required, so that was what was tripping me up. And it's an easy thing to get tripped up on if you aren't paying attention to it. And as noted, it can be kind of difficult to troubleshoot. So, but things are working now. Our code coverage still 100%. So we're good there. Take a look at what we've got in our backlog and see if there's anything else we can sneak in. I don't think I want to I don't have any more small things, so I think we're just gonna commit what we have, and the next ones will get their own episodes. So make sure RuboCop where is RuboCop getting angry? Randomization technique, line 9. Now we're good. RSpec's good. Add all of our code. Commit it, write our message. So I've got my message, I'll sign it. Push to the branch. Move our item to done, presumptuously. but I was validated in my presumption, so there we have it.
Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.